Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to Bioshock Infinite Burial at Sea. So, episode 2, you know, after episode 1, we finished episode 1, and we'll look through a little previously thing, because why not? I wonder how they'll go about it.
They told me, son, you were born to do great things. They were right.
I thought this was going to be about DLC 1, not about all of Bioshock.
I'm Atlas, and I aim to keep you alive. You think that's a child down there? She's a little sister now. Somebody went and turned a sweet baby girl into a monster.
It's Ryan! Goddamn Andrew Ryan! Head to medical!
Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly find that home? Would you kindly find that? Would you kindly get this? Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Did that airplane crash? Or was it hijacked?
There ain't no Atlas, kid. The name's Frank Fontaine.
I had you built! I sent you topside! I called you back, showed you what you was, what you was capable of! Even that life you thought you had, that was something I dreamed of.
You saved them. You gave them the one thing that was stolen from them. A chance.
Bioshock 2, right? Because why would you need to focus on that? What did you need to... I guess this is because this is going to be the events after the first game. But we're playing in 1998 mode. It's basically like you can't kill anybody. So... I thought they were going to do like a previous video of the DLC. Not that.
Sally! Sally, come out!
She wasn't yours, Comstock.
Elizabeth, I am so sorry.
No, you're
not. You will be.
But you're about to be.
So, I guess this is like right after the events. What the hell? Are you in Paris, finally? Damn, finally in Paris, ain't you, Elizabeth?
Yes.
Quel est votre nom?
Elizabeth.
Pour vous, Elizabeth.
Oh, no. No, I couldn't. I can't accept...
Je vous en prie. J'insiste. Oh,
thank you.
That kid's really just fucking bouncing around with a baguette. It's interesting that we're playing as Elizabeth. Didn't think that would happen.
Bonjour, mademoiselle.
But there's a part of Elizabeth out there that did get... That did get to come to Paris.
Bonjour, monsieur Surratt.
Bonjour, mademoiselle Elizabeth. Je manque d'inspiration aujourd'hui.
She goes around everywhere, huh?
Bien le bonjour, mademoiselle.
Me bonjour, mon petit trésor.
Je vais te croquer.
Bonjour.
Yes. So basically, you probably are looking like at the difficulty and probably thinking like, whoa, dude, did you just pick like the hardest difficulty? From what I read, the difficulty is normal. The only difference here is there's like no killing.
Comment ça va, Elizabeth?
Like you're not allowed to kill anybody. So basically, it's like a stealth thing is what this DLC is about.
Bonjour, Elizabeth.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, Elizabeth. Bonjour.
Comment allez-vous?
Man, she's like, bonjour, she's with everybody here.
Alors, tu as parlé à la jolie petite américaine? Oh, bonjour, mademoiselle.
She's like fucking famous here,
bonjour.
Almost.
Comment ça va, Elisabeth?
Bonne journée. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
Everyone's nice.
Et si tu venais boire un verre avec nous?
Claude?
Sois pas jalouse, ma petite. C'est pas interdit pour un homme de boire avec deux jolies filles.
Only because this is some fucking dream that's gonna explode.
I'm sorry, Cosette. Next time, I promise.
Dommage.
You look like a fucking dude.
Bien le bonjour, mademoiselle.
Oh, you got the rabbits. Bro,
bien
this
bonjour,
is just a fucking
Elizabeth.
Dream.
Bonjour, mademoiselle. Comment allez-vous?
This whole place is about to fucking implode. It's too
baguette,
bright.
Baguette, mademoiselle?
No baguettes today.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, Elizabeth.
Huh. Man, that's how you know this place is still fucked up. Why is this dog still tied up? Come to dance, Elizabeth. Oh no, a red balloon. Pennywise. This is actually a little sister.
Sally.
Oh yeah, I knew it was
Sally.
Bullshit. It's got dark. Where did everybody go? Bingo? Oh, the bird. Wait, is that. Crows. I thought the birds were dying. They always have this kind of nightmare escape thing.
Sally, wait!
Place is on fire.
Sally, stop!
Come back!
Sally, where are you going?
Come back!
Sally, hold on!
Come back!
You're about to, like, go down the damn place where where your dad lost you.
Where did she go?
About to hear a fucking blood curdling scream.
Go away. It wasn't my fault. I didn't do anything.
Oh.
No, it wasn't my fault. I never should have left you there.
Oh, look. So you just pass out after he fucking died? Oh no, you were. Things went bad.
Empty.
I didn't have any ammo at all, dude.
Just having a bit of a laugh, Atlas.
This ain't a sporting event. Put a bullet in her. No need to torture the poor girl. We're not animals, you know.
All right.
Let her go!
Quiet down, dear. In a minute, all your problems will be over.
Elizabeth, tell him you can get him back.
Booker? What?
Say,
I don't understand. How?
Say... I can get you back to Rapture.
What?
Just say it.
I can get you back to Rapture.
Put the gun down.
Now, what was that you said about Rapture?
I could get you back to Rapture.
And how you plan on doing that, sister? You some kind of magician?
Suchong.
What?
Tell him Suchong.
Suchong.
And how do you know that, slant-eyed wonder?
You're his lab assistant.
I'm his lab assistant.
If it escaped your notice, Andrew Ryan sunk us 5,000 fathoms below his shining city. How does Suchong propose to get us back?
That's between me.
That's between me.
And the slant.
And the slant. But if I do this, the girl goes with me.
The little sisters are worth their weight in gold. She's not up for negotiation.
Last time I checked, back in the city they were making little sisters by the dozen.
That's a right fairy tale you've dreamed up, sister. But if you're lying, we can just as well kill you tomorrow. Down here, we got nothing but time.
The
council needs to get hold of you. If you see Suchong, tell him Atlas says he hasn't forgotten
him. Ow! Why do they need a punch in the subtitle? Was taken away.
Well, of course I ain't.
What have I gotten myself into? I didn't orphan that girl. I didn't kidnap her.
But she made for some exceptional fate, didn't she?
Had to be done.
Did it?
I felt everything that every version of me felt. All of that knowledge. I lost a pinky, but that version of me, she lost everything.
Damn, bro.
Comstock. That final Comstock. He thought he could avoid his guilt by coming here.
You educated him proper.
But then why am I back here? Huh? I don't remember opening a tear to come back. And who are you? Huh?
I think you'll figure that out soon enough.
Whole place is fucked up. Where do I actually go?
I was in Paris. I was happy. And now I'm here dealing with this Atlas, psychopath. What was I thinking?
That wasn't Paris any more than I am, Booker.
Now I have to find this Suchong, and I don't even know who that is.
Not yet, but you know he's the key, don't you?
To what?
You're asking me. Elizabeth, I ain't even here.
Bro, I'm gonna fucking be out there in the water and see a sign that just says toys. Oh, she still has her air hook. She'll be doing executions just like her dad.
What are you? Huh? And how did you know exactly what to tell Atlas?
Let me ask you a question. Feeling like yourself, Elizabeth.
I feel strange and smaller. I can't see the doors. What's behind the doors? I can't see the future. I can't even see any tears. Oh my god. Stay away from me. Booker. No. No. No, please. Please, no. By that. Stay away from me! But then, how am I here? How can I be dead in this world and yet... My finger. What am I? Huh? I don't understand. I...
If we're going to end up in the same place, it's a harm in general. come round to your way of thinking.
Oh my God, she's going through exactly what her dad went through. Things,
but after all the bother, one often wishes that one had not.
You're a fatalist.
A physicist.
A fatalist.
So was Newton, especially when it came to apples falling from trees. They always contrive to land with a splat. She left the child to rot.
Are you implying she's the apple?
I'm implying that she did not fall far from the tree.
And now she wants to go back.
I need to go back. To fix what I broke.
Back to where she has no right to be.
Back to where she doesn't belong.
Doesn't belong? Wait, what do you mean?
Do you want to tell her brother, or shall I?
Because I died.
There are rules.
Even for one such as you.
She'll forget.
All the doors.
And what's behind all the doors.
All closed to her now.
She'll be just like the rest of us.
Forgetting the past.
The present.
The future.
I'd wager she won't even remember this conversation. We've arrived. You're trading omniscience and croissance for death and mildew.
I left Sally to rot. For what? So I could punish Comstock? He was trying to help her, to save her, and I... If I don't make that right...
We all have our crosses to bear.
But there is a thin line between a martyr and a fool.
How do I hear them perfectly?
The Lutesses warned me that if I came back here, I would collapse.
Collapse?
From a quantum superposition to just me.
Quantum what?
I've changed, Booker. No tears, no cosmic knowledge. Just a normal girl. A normal pinky. Peter, if I can't open tears, I'm never leaving here, am I? I'm never going back to Paris. You're just what? You're just the fragments of my memory telling me what my future holds?
You decided to come here, Elizabeth. You knew what that meant. Only option, as I see it, is to trust yourself. Find Su Chong.
Why are these DLCs so dark? Like, I only see myself. The screen's black. I can see myself sitting here.
Relationships, compensation.
I think I'm gonna have to use this air grabber. It's gonna be messy, I don't know.
Well, a blow to the back of his head will serve just as well. Be a hell of a lot quieter, too.
That's not what you would have done.
I'm not Booker. Just because your father did something one way, doesn't mean you have to.
Come on, man. Let's work something out.
To get the drop on him and quiet.
Yeah, this is all about stuff.
You can't hear what's only in your head.
He's not getting up anytime soon.
And what with his head all attached to his body?
From here on, it's only gonna get worse.
And how much worse is up to you.
Children, a clay, Bradburn.
Yeah, this is why I'm playing in the 1998 mode, because, like, if this is all really just going to be stealth, then, yeah, it's fine.
Get them young enough. You can mold them for life. Henry! Fetch that black label lacquer, the 12-year-old single malt. Let's discuss this like this.
Now, let's get his lockpick.
could be items around. Probably not gonna be much of anything around since... fuck it. Let's just move on, I guess. Oh, hell.
Lockpicking can be easy with the right tools and know-how. Use your lockpick to probe a pin. A neutral pin will open the door. A blue pin will open the door and knock free a noisemaker. A red pin will open the door, but also sound...
Oh, I get what you're doing. Yeah, this is classic.
Just a 6-pin tumbler. But there's an alarm. That could come in handy, though.
Yeah, I know what this is. Oh, there is no blue. Okay. So it's like it's just like the other Bioshock games. Very easy. I was pretty good at doing all that in Bioshock 2.
I'm here to tell you about Peter the Parasite.
What the?
If I bake a pie, isn't it mine to enjoy? No, says Peter the Parasite. We all deserve a piece. If I earn a nickel, isn't it my right to buy candy if I see fit? No, says Peter the Parasite. You must only buy fruits and vegetables. If I can afford to see the doctor, is it my concern that others cannot? No, says the damnable parasite. We must all crowd our way into the physician's office. Ryan the lion says, chew on that, you parasite.
Damn. They all want to kill the parasite. Of course they call him Ryan the lion. Shit, what crossbow?
Sure you're ready to use that?
It's a crossbow. Looks like the bolt delivers some kind of sleep agent. Probably phencyclidine or sodium thiopental. They had all kinds of books in my tower. How do you think I always knew what ammo to toss you?
Knowing ain't the same as being ready.
Why don't you ask Comstock how ready I was?
Your father's blood runs in your veins, but it doesn't have to be on your hands. It's up to you.
Those who cannot create will always steal from those who do. Where is your empathy? Asks Peter the Parasite while he picks your pocket. You know this word.
So, basically, I could do the whole skyhook thing, it's just that I need to be quiet while I do it. So I do that, I need to immediately get down. Okay, I understand. Seems easy enough.
If that's what they call a fellow who's prosperous, determined, uncompromising, then fine. The shoe fits, you got me.
Where is he?
Bassman, that's what this is. Incessant, unbounded prying into my respectable entrepreneurial affairs.
Where the fuck is he? Let's go back up here. See in here?
Seems to me you're against a guy making an honest buck. I thought the rapture was open for business.
Sounds like Yuri Lowenthal. I doubt Elizabeth's gonna get any money.
What of it? I've been told this town was friendly to free enterprise. That's what they call a fellow who's prosperous, determined, uncompromising, then fine. The shoe fits. You got me.
Quiet! Oh, we do get money as Elizabeth, okay. DLC is definitely going to end up taking longer than the other one, because I gotta stealth my way through things. But everybody knows I'm no good at stealth. Oh. That doesn't look good.
Look, Sucho. That's the name you had me tell Atlas. Huh.
I don't follow.
Looks like this character Suchong has taken over the Silverfin restaurant. That's where the tear was that I used when I first came to Rapture looking for Comstock. Before this place was turned into a prison.
But the first time you came to Rapture was in 1960, with Booker. When you drowned the song.
Over a year from now. Yeah, that's right. When I could see all the doors, it all made sense, but now. Now it's just a jungle.
Elizabeth, you're bleeding.
Now I know what it feels like. All right, if we're gonna find Suchong, the Silverfin is the place to start. I know the way.
So wait, hold on. This is the same Elizabeth, because I think she just said something about, you know, when Booker was drowned.
Right after I came through, I needed something to wear that was a little more Rapture appropriate.
That's Rapture appropriate? Oh, I mean, it is appetite for sin.
Well, he didn't have these books in my tower.
Uh-oh, this is the adult place. Huh.
Dear madam, I have received your letter regarding our new line of Peeping Tom plasmids and wish to respond thusly.
Peeping Tom?
Tough luck. This is Rapture, miss. What my customers do with my product is their business. If you are feeling uncomfortable, you are more than welcome to line the walls of your home in lead. If you wish, I could direct you to a reputable supplier.
Huh. Well, it's your dress.
There you are.
How many times have I asked Antonio for lockers with actual locks on them? Come back from lunch, and the ensemble I just bought is gone. Stolen! But here's what takes the cake. The thief left an outfit in exchange. At first, I was gonna toss that thing, but then I kind of fell in love with it. It's an old-timey number with a corset, no less. It ain't exactly today's fashion.
Peeping Tom.
Disappear from sight. See through walls. And sneak up on your foes.
But okay. I'm a girl who can tell good craftsmanship when she sees.
Splicers. I could use this plasmid and see them through the walls.
Come on!
Worst comes to worst, you're completely invisible and get the drop on them. We'd all be better off, us Stewits, if we could leave well enough alone.